Marlon Anderson, Comcast Sportsnet, pre and post game for Phillies. And it looked like, Marlon, you guys were not going to have a lot of fun things to talk about those first couple of games. But, boy, that starting pitching staff the last couple of nights and today has given you guys plenty to talk about. These young arms, you can see why the Phillies were targeting some of these guys, especially Velasquez today in that Giles deal.
Oh, no, not about it. I think when you have guys that come up and step up like they have in the last few starts, and they're all so young and, you know, so inexperienced in the big league, but to not have that experience but step up early in the season and not to walk anybody, I think that's the key. Young pitchers usually get themselves in trouble when they're walking guys left and right, and by them not walking people, giving the defense a chance and just throwing strikes and having good stuff all together, I think that's what's surprising about all of it.
Now, Marlon, you know, and young pitchers, you mentioned they have problems with, you know, that's one of the problems, that their command. What impressed you so much about Velasquez? Because, you know, from what I saw early in the game, he was dominating with really one pitch. And, you know, that's not a lot of time. Like, Eichhoff last night was using the curve a lot. Today, Velasquez, he was just throwing the ball by people. That was what was impressive to me about both of these guys' outings, the command that they had of their pitches.
Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, young guys with command is awesome because you give yourself a chance. But I think Velasquez with that fastball, he established it in that first inning. And I think it built the confidence in himself to be able to know, like, you know what, I can throw my fastball and they can't hit it. And you're like that with a pitcher and you're throwing 95 to 97, you know, even when he started the ball at the bottom of the zone, it wasn't dropping out of the zone. It had a little bit more life on it. And it was just, you know, he was throwing it past guys. I literally like had no chance. So that's the thing. When you're throwing your fastball, you're spotting it, but your ball's not dropping out of zone. It's taking off and had extra life to it.
Marlon Anderson's with us. Phillies win today. It's another shutout, 3-0, 16 strikeouts for Vince Velasquez. And last night, Eichhoff with another great game as well. But I want to shift to that bullpen real fast, Marlon. They didn't need it today, but Jenmar Gomez has come in. Has he displayed enough to make you feel like they found a little diamond in the rough there? I mean, I know the bullpen's not going to be a strong suitor, most likely won't be, but did they find a little something with him at the back end?
I think he stepped into an opportunity, and as long as he's doing well, he'll be fine. He doesn't have closer stuff, I guess I'll say. Got a good sinker. I think that sinker will always be his best pitch, but he's going to have to trick some guys. He's going to have to hope they hit it to his defense. He's going to have to do all those little things to stay relevant as a closer, because he doesn't have that blow-by stuff, I guess, or even stuff that, you know, that nasty off-speed pitch that didn't scare you.
Marlon Anderson with...
I'm sorry, but he has stepped into a role that, you know, it's good for him. You know, he's taking advantage of it, and I think that's what you have to do with a team. And, you know, the guys are not great, but they do have two situations where they're going to have a chance to succeed.
Marlon Anderson with us here on the Sports Bash on 97.3 ESPN FM, CSN Philly pre and post for the Phillies. Spending a couple days up here watching the hometown team as he talks about the fightings. And how about Ryan Howard, Marlon? Because a home run today, and Mike Gill and I talked about the fact that if not for the injury to Ruff, he might not have been in the lineup.
Yeah, that's always an interesting conversation. I think, you know, for me, I believe that, you know, he needs every now and then to hit against lefties, because as a left-handed hitter, when you're facing lefties, it keeps you tucked inside, keeps your arm in. You know you can't get the job done if you pull it off, and it helps him stay short to the ball, which I like for him. But again, you know, you do what you have to do for your team. They've already established a role. He's going to take advantage of it, and, you know, I think he's going to be fine. You know, whatever they want to do. The platoon is great, but for me, I would love to see him play, not get pinch hit for, I guess I'll say, early in the game, sixth inning like he did the other day, because later in the game, all closers, most of the setup men in the game today are right-handed, so I want to keep his bat in the lineup late in the game.
Well, you and I talked up at Comcast about Philly's third baseman. I know how much you love Scott Rolen, but let's talk about the current third baseman, Michael Franco, and where you see him going. I mean, the sky's the limit on him, right?
Oh, it is. You know, he's a special player, and what I like about him is him being so young and the adjustments he can make quick adjustments. You know, he's not a guy who's going to pull off an extended amount of time, because he knows in order for him to be good, he has to stay through the ball, hit the ball to the right side, take those base hits to the other side, which is going to keep his average up, it's going to keep his confidence up, and he's shown you in the last couple of days that he can drive the ball out of the ballpark, which is going to be key for him, too.
How much did you read into the Blanco start today as an endorsement of trying to get him in the lineup, or was it more, let's get Galvis a rest a little bit and maybe try to get his head straight?
Well, it's one thing when you watch a team every day and you want to have those same eight guys out there. But me, you know, finishing my career up as a bench player, I know how important it is. And most managers know how important it is to get that guy a start every now and then to keep him fresh. So when you really need him to come in and pinch hit or do something else, he's fresh and he can get it done. So it's more about getting that bats for Blanco, which they need to do. Just like they're mixing guys around in the outfield, Blanco's got to get some at bats because he's an effective player, number one. He brings a lot to the table when you get him in the lineups.
Marlon Anderson's with us. The Phillies win today 3-0. Marlon, of course, Comcast Sportsnet pre- and post-game. Today, the Phillies win with a shutout, 16 strikeouts from Vincent Velasquez. And they've played really good baseball here, but obviously the offense has been a little bit of an issue. Do you see any possibilities of the offense turning around? We always heard Charlie say, you know, it's not hitting weather yet. You know, is there more to this offense, or is this what we should be expect? Is it going to be these low scoring, you know, games where you're going to have to rely on the pitching, you know, 80% of these games?
Well, I really think that it's going to be tough hitting wise. I don't think they just have the caliber of bats in their organization, on their team right now, that they're going to be a team that's going to go out and score you 6-7 runs a night. You know, it's going to be the pitching that keeps you in games, and hopefully you can do the little things to be able to add a run here, you know, hit and run sometimes, moving guys over, getting them in from third base with less than 2 outs. Those are the things that's going to keep them and give them a chance, because they're not going to be this hitting juggernaut that they have been in the past.
No, they obviously used to be a great offensive bunch, but who are some of the guys that impress you? Some of the, you just mentioned the caliber of bats. They don't have them, Marlon, but you got a keen eye for these things. Who are some guys, you know, they're younger guys out there. Who impresses you? Who looks like they have a good approach?
Well, of course, Franco does, and I love everything about Herrera, his hand-eye coordination, how he's explosive for a little guy with his swing, but, you know, you'll see he'll take a big swing, but he stays – still get the barrel to the ball. He figures out a way to get the barrel to the ball. I actually like Hernandez. You know, it's something about, you know, being a switch hitter. He's got a little speed, but, you know, he'll battle at the plate. He's not gonna, just going to give you outs, give outs away. And I actually like Cameron Rupp behind home plate. I think early in the season, I think the first 100 games of the season that he catches, I think he's going to have more pop than you'll expect from him. But I think as he catches more games, he's definitely, the legs are going to go a little bit. He won't have as much power, but he can definitely draw the ball in the gap. And he's a very confident player. You saw him today behind the plate, control that. And other than that, it's good stuff right now. You know, the young kids that are in the minor leagues that they have some hope for, but it's going to be tough going, mixing and matching and trying to get the best results out of the guys. You know, it's gonna be a chess game sometimes out there with the hitting.
You know, Herrera's an interesting guy. Rule 5, and then today he walked 3 times, and, you know, he's a free wild swinger, but it looks like, you know, he's getting more disciplined. But, you know, for a Rule 5 guy, last year he led the team in hitting. It looks like they really found a gem here. My question really is, though, you're a guy that changed position. You know, you were second base and then kind of moved around. He was a second baseman. Do you look at him as a center fielder? Is that where you think his best spot is?
Oh, no doubt about it. I definitely think so. I actually had I coached a little bit in the minor leagues, and I saw him play shortstop. And again, with those same actions that you see at the plate, at shortstop, he had those fast switch muscles. And, you know, if he caught it, sometimes he'd throw it away. If he didn't catch it, you know, get an error there. Like, he did a lot of weird stuff, I think, out in the field at shortstop. So I think center field is definitely the best position for him. I think as he gets older and later on, I think left field, you know, he's got to be able to shift over to left field if you get a more experienced, better center fielder that can go out there and actually roam around and be good. But center field, he's adequate. He's made a quick adjustment out there, and you have to, you know, of course, the hard work that he's put in and everything is the reason for it. But, you know, I wouldn't change anything right now in that sense.
Marlon Anderson with us, one of two Marlins ever to play Major League Baseball. Marlon Byrd, of course, the second. Then you guys were teammates on a couple teams. I look at your resume, Marlon. It's Mets, Nationals, Dodgers, Mets again, and, of course, the Philadelphia Phillies. And so nobody probably more uniquely qualified than you to talk about the Philly fan. When you were over at the ballpark, I saw that picture with Key and Peele. What was the atmosphere like, and how do you think the fans are doing in their support of this team, being that it's so young and they're not quite sure what to expect?
Well, because the expectations were so low, I think what they're getting right now, they're excited about it. And to get 3 out of 4 in their first homestand, come in, you get the 3 pitching gems that they got the last 3 days. I think fans are overly excited about what, and you know, I think people, you know, even over at the Comcast Studios today, you know, people are excited. You know, they're talking about, like, you know, well, can we be better than what we thought? And, you know, and I always say, you know, the bottom line is you have to get those games in. They're young kids. The best part of what's happened, you know, they're playing teams that are not in their division, that hadn't seen them much. And with these new pitchers, these teams haven't faced them at all. So they have no video on these guys. Like Velasquez, there was no video on him before his first start. But they'll build video. Teams will start to have more of a scouting report against the guy. And there will be adjustments to be made. But what you're seeing out of the pitching staff now, as long as they can throw strikes, they're going to be in some games. Now, if they start getting hit around, how their emotions going to handle that from game to game? So it's a lot of growth and a lot of learning that this particular team and this staff is going to have to go through. But I like the arms. I like the intensity. I like the confidence that they have when they're out on the mound right now.
Hey, I had no idea when we talked the other night, and I brought up the name C.B. Buckner, that, of course, you know him well from that play when you were with the Mets. And so I guess that leads me to ask you about the Chase Utley rule and your thoughts on that.
Well, I'm not about changing baseball. I think, you know, if they'd handle it the correct way and somebody has a, you know, a slide that's not right and that's bad and that's wrong, that's, you know, people consider dirty or illegal or whatever, if you suspend that person, I think you solve the problem and not have to worry about changing the rule, which for me, I don't like, because I think it changes in the baseball, you know, being around second base and shortstop or second, it's a special place to be. It's a special position to play, and you used to have to be athletic and, you know, on your toes. Now it's kind of taking that away and making everything. I mean, I love the guys to bear down me at second base when I was turning a double play or doing something. That was the part of the game that I knew separated me from other guys being able to play that position. So now, if I can get a slide straight into the bag and you can't try to, you know, it's one of those funny rules that the majority of, well, I'll say probably 100% of second baseman and shortstop that I've talked to about this rule, they hate it because it takes away something that they do that's special that allowed them to be who they are. So,
Marlon Anderson, everybody, Phillies pre- and post-game, Comcast Sportsnet, and, of course, we are happy to have him jump on board. I understand that PT was producing. How the heck how do you make it through a show with him telling you what to do?
It was easy for me. It's the host that was, you know, they had to, you know, read the prompter and, you know, take all the questions and do all this stuff. They probably had a little bit more of a time. But for me, I'm just sitting there being me talking about the game that I love so much.
I was going to say, if he's not telling you something to say in your ear,
no
way.
I stayed out of his ear. Poor Michael Barkhead got it both barrels.
Yeah, no, definitely. It's one of those things that you have a little fun with it. That's the great thing about this business. A lot of people, and a lot of people produce, and they have different ideas and different things they want to talk about, and that's what makes the show, I think, different every day, is, you know, those producers and directors and people who have that insight to different things that they want to talk about and listen to. I think that's what makes it fun for everybody.
Well, we like your baseball knowledge, and we hope to catch up again. Real quick, one more way to put Velasquez in perspective. This is from Jason Stark. 16 strikeouts, no walks, complete game shutout. The only other active pitcher who has ever done that is Max Scherzer, who had 17 strikeouts and a no-hitter in that game. So Vincent Velasquez had a hell of a game today. Marlon Anderson, Comcast Sportsnet. Thank you, Marlon.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.